Many people call it the unfinished portrait. It's located on the second floor of the building in the Gallery of the Governors. Now, John Swainson served as governor for one term in the early 1960s. He was in office 1961 to 62. At the time, a term was only 2 years long. That would change with the 1963 Constitution. Now, John Swainson was not new to the Capitol building. He had served in the state Senate previously, and then he was lieutenant governor under Soapy Williams, G. Menon Williams, for his last term in office in the late 1950s. So John Swainson was a young man when he served in the governor's office. In fact, not the youngest, but one of the youngest governors we have had. And he was not reelected at the end of that 2-year term. So he was done serving as governor when he was only 37 years old. Now, we had the opportunity to meet the artist of this portrait many years ago. His name was Stephen, or sometimes he went by Pablo Davis. And he told us how when he went to paint the portrait, he wanted it to reflect the governor's youth and the fact that he was still a young man and still had plenty of years before him. So he painted Governor Swainson actually stepping out of the governor's office. You'll recognize the black and white tile floor that he stands on. And his face is not clearly defined, which suggests that he's still developing. This gives rise to the idea that the portrait is in some ways unfinished to reflect the unfinished nature of his career. Though in truth, it is finished in the sense that this is how it was intended to appear. What I find very remarkable, though, about the portrait is the way the governor's legs are depicted. John Swainson was a World War II veteran. He served with distinction in Europe. And while in France, he suffered a very bad accident, and he actually lost both of his legs as a result. He was a double amputee. Now, this was not always something that we talked about very publicly at that time in American culture. Of course, think about the fact that FDR was president during World War II and went so far out of his way to make sure that he was never photographed in a wheelchair because, of course, he had suffered from polio. Swainson, though, was very open about his disability and actually used his platform as governor to reach out to other individuals who had suffered similar accidents. In fact, years ago, when I was giving a tour, I met a woman who had worked in the building in the 60s when Swainson was here. And he found out that her sister had recently had an amputation and was in the local hospital. Well, unbeknownst to everyone, save for a couple members of his staff, he scheduled time to go visit her. So completely unannounced, he walked into her hospital room, sat down in the chair next to her bed after introducing himself, and started to pull up a pant leg and took off one of his prosthetic limbs. And if you talk to people who worked for him and knew him when he was governor, he did this all the time because he felt that as governor, he should use his position to encourage and inspire others. And that woman, 40 some years later, still spoke in glowing terms as she told that story because it was a reminder that Governor Swainson was an extraordinary man. He had overcome huge obstacles to become governor, but he was also dedicated to reaching out to ordinary, everyday people. And he was able to connect with dozens of people across the state and change their concept of their future. He was a remarkable, inspiring man. And we have the privilege of sharing those stories about Governor Swainson every day, thanks to this wonderful portrait.